Hey everyone, welcome to today's video where we are diving into the heart of every computing device, the CPU, and exploring how RISC-V is changing the game when it comes to CPU design. Whether you are a tech enthusiast or someone looking to understand processor design, stay tuned because we are going to make this fun and easy to understand. Alright, let's start with the basics. What is a CPU? The CPU or central processing unit is like the brain of your computer. It's responsible for executing the instructions that make your applications run. Think of it as the conductor of an orchestra, coordinating and processing tasks in real time. Whether you are playing a video game, calculating numbers in a spreadsheet, or simply browsing the internet, the CPU is behind it all, processing instructions at lightning speed to make it happen. So, what makes up all this important brain? Let's break it down into four key components. Number one, arithmetic logic unit, ALU, the CPU's calculator. It handles arithmetic operations like addition and subtraction, and logical comparison like and or and many more. Number two, the control unit. This is the CPU's boss. It decodes instruction and coordinates all the components to ensure everything runs smoothly. Number three, registers. These are like the CPU scratch pad. They store temporary data and help the CPU process instructions much faster. Number four is memory interface, the CPU's librarian. It fetches the data from memory so the CPU can use it to process information. These components work together to ensure your computer performs any task from running software to solving complex computation. Now, let's talk about how the CPU actually works. The CPU follows a simple cycle called Fetch-Decode-Execute cycle. What does the fetch do? Fetch, the CPU grabs as instruction from memory. Number two, decode. It decodes that instruction to understand what needs to be done. Number third is execute. The CPU then performs the action, whether it's a maths operation or moving data. And the last but not the least is write back. Finally, it writes the result back into registers or memory. This process happens millions of times per second, enabling your device to run smoothly. Before we dive into RISC-V, let's quickly explore two different computer architecture types. Number one is complex instruction set computer, CISC. Six CPUs have a large number of complex instructions. They can do more in fewer lines of code, but tend to be more power hungry and complex to design. Number two is reduced instruction set computer, RISC. RISC CPUs, on the other hand, use simpler, fewer instructions, but they execute those instructions much faster. This results in better performance and power efficiency, especially in modern devices. And that brings us to RISC-V, a new take on RISC architecture. So, what is RISC-V and why is it making waves in the tech world? RISC-V is an open source, free to use instruction set architecture, ISA, that gaining a lot of attention in both academia and industry. It's designed to be flexible and scalable, allowing developers to customize and extend the base architecture for a variety of applications, whether it's for a small microcontroller or high performance server processor. What makes RISC-V so exciting? Here are its key features. Number one is modularity. You can add or remove extensions as needed, making it highly customizable. Number two, scalability. RISC-V can be used in everything from simple embedded system to complex server processor. Number 3. Open source. Because it's free to use and backed by a global community, anyone can contribute to and improve it. Number 4 is performance. RISC-V is built for efficient execution, which makes it perfect for modern computing needs, from low power devices to high performance applications. Now, why should you consider using RISC-V when designing a CPU? Number 1 is customization. You are not locked into predefined architecture. You can pick and choose what suits your application, whether you need high performance for AI or low power consumption for IoT devices. Number 2 is no licensing fees. Unlike other architectures like ARM or x86, RISC-V doesn't require expensive licensing. That makes it accessible to everyone, from startups to big enterprises. Number 3 is rapid innovation. With a global community constantly developing new extensions and features, RISC-V is evolving fast. RISC-V isn't just a theoretical concept. It's already making a splash in various industries. Number 1 is artificial intelligence. Companies are using RISC-V to design AI accelerators that efficiently handle machine learning tasks. Some of the companies are working on 5G networks. Its low power, high performance nature makes it ideal for next-gen telecom infrastructure. The third application is of automotive. RISC-V is being used in real-time control system for autonomous driving and smart vehicles. Last but not the least, IoT and embedded systems. Thanks to its simplicity and low energy requirements, RISC-V is a perfect fit for devices like wearables and smart sensors. Designing a RISC-V CPU is similar to designing any other CPU, with the familiar key components. Number 1, which is ALU, the arithmetic logic unit that processes all arithmetic and logical operations. Control unit decodes the instruction based on the RISC-V instruction set and orchestrates the execution. Registers. General purpose register stores immediate data for quick access. Memory interface retrieves instruction and data from memory. RISC-V allows for adding extensions like vector instructions, floating point operations, or even custom instructions, making it versatile for a wide range of applications. So, there you have it, a brief introduction to CPU design and how RISC-V is reshaping the future of processors. Whether you are building embedded systems, developing AI accelerators, or working on high-performance computing, RISC-V gives you the flexibility and freedom to design CPUs tailored to your exact need. If you found this tutorial helpful, hit that like button and subscribe for more content. In upcoming videos, we will be designing a RISC-V single-cycle core from scratch and creating existing exciting projects step by step. If you got any questions or ideas for future topics, drop them in the comments below. Until next time, keep creating and stay curious.